When presenting numerical data to your audience, sometimes a chart is just what you need to help them see the meaning behind the numbers. For example, I have our bookstore's sales figures organized by genre and year in this table, but it's hard to see any trends without looking at the numbers one by one. I think a chart would make things much easier. We'll first go to the Insert tab, and then click the Chart command to open a list of our choices. Let's take a look at some of the more common ones. Column charts are good all-around charts. They work with many different types of data, whereas line charts are best for showing trends over time. Pie charts are unique because they let you see your data in proportion instead of on a graph. We also have the bar chart, which is basically just a column chart turned on its side, and area charts are like line charts, except the areas under the lines are filled in. I think I'll start with something in the column category. There are lots of styles to choose from. This one looks nice and simple. Click OK, and then something interesting happens. An Excel window opens. Why? Well, PowerPoint uses an Excel worksheet as the placeholder for your chart data. You enter your information here, right on top of the placeholder text, and it shows up on the chart. See? Let's just add the rest of the genres to this column. Now all we need to do is fill in our sales figures. We're going to be covering the last 5 years, from 2006 to 2010. Anything you want to include on your chart has to be inside this little blue box, so I'm going to drag the bottom right corner to make some more room. And Excel automatically finishes the series with 2009 and 2010. To save us some more time, I'm going to copy and paste the rest of the data from a spreadsheet I already have. Just open the existing worksheet. Copy the data you want to use, then paste it in the placeholder. Notice how the chart in PowerPoint was updated right away? There's no need to save, not even when you close the Excel window, because PowerPoint automatically keeps up with you while you work. To go back and make changes, all you have to do is click the Edit Data command, and the Excel window will open again. You can even import a chart from Excel, which is what I was planning to do on the next slide. I like this feature because it lets you repurpose an existing chart, and you can keep it up to date by linking it to the original. Just go to Insert, Object, and choose Create from File. Browse to find the right file on your computer. Then check the link box if you want to create that link, meaning that any changes you make to the original will be reflected here too. Just be careful not to move or delete the original file. If the location of either the PowerPoint or the Excel file changes, you may have to insert the chart again in order for it to display properly. And here's our second chart, a pie chart this time. Charts can be as simple or as complex as you like in PowerPoint. I think the audience will appreciate how easy it is to understand the data when it's visualized in such a clear way.
Like what you just saw? Rate it.
Add a comment.
Subscribe to our channel.
The freedom to learn.
What you want, when you want.
Absolutely free.
GCFLearnFree.org.